today's event is formerly headed the Mayor's Charity Concert, but this time it's a little bit different. Usually it's a concert with some great acts from Stevenage, young people and not so young people, in a traditional format. But this time the Mayor's attempted to do something else, and I think he succeeded. In a shorter show, no interval, a rolling programme of song and dance, and some narration in between us. That's part of my role.
So today's theme is the environment, and I think that's important because we really just need to raise awareness of the environment and help people to understand that we do need to take care of our world.
Hi, I'm Matt Partridge. I'm the Chief Executive of Stevenage Borough Council. I'm here tonight to support the Our Environment One World event. Why am I here? Well, I'm here to support the Mayor with a really important event in the calendar and to support the charities that he's obviously supporting this year as the Mayor as well.
Hello, my name's Aidan. I've got something to show you, a little bit of magic. I don't know if you know what these are. They look a little bit like string, don't they? But they're not string, because string is thin, and these are rope. Ropes are fat. I think that means that string is rope that's been on a diet. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I don't think I counted that right. 1 in that hand and 2 in that hand, that makes 3. 3 pieces of rope that are all exactly the same size. Well, they are at that end. Perhaps if I could make all of the ends the same, that would sort the problem out. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ends, all exactly the same size. So now the ropes are the same. I've got a problem with the middles. Perhaps if you could give it a blow, I'll do it too. And then maybe we'll have 1, 2, 3 pieces of rope where one of them is the same size as 2 of them, which is the same size as 3 of them. So if a magician stands here and he tells you that he's got 1 piece of rope that's the same size as 2 pieces of rope, that's the same size as 3 pieces, did I just go like that? Do you know what happens if you go like that? You have 1 piece of rope, you have 2 pieces of rope, you have 3 pieces of rope where one of them is short, one of them is long, and one of them is somewhere in the middle, just like it was at the beginning. I wonder what your eyesight's like. I hope it's good. Do you know how many spots I've got there? Just the 1. And on the other side, I've got 4. But the strange thing is that this side has got 3, and this side has got 6. I'm cheating. You probably worked it out. You see, on the other side, I haven't really got 1, and I haven't got 3. I've just got 2 with a gap. And on this side, I haven't really got 4 or 6. I've just got 5 with a gap. So all you have to do is get yourself a piece of cardboard and write 5 spots on that side and 2 spots on that side. And you seem to have 3 on that side. Anyway, if you've got 5 spots on that side, 3 on that side, you won't be able to do the trick. But with 3 on that side and 6 on that side, there's 8 now. I better stop because we're getting a bit too spotty in this trick. I wonder if you know what these are. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll put those down over there. Now, it's very important that they haven't got holes in. Some people think they have right through the middle, but I'm talking about right down the end there. Now, this one has to be as far away from that one is from this one. And as long as they're apart, I can show you the trick. So I'm gonna, seems to be a problem. I'll take these ones and I'll just pick one of those up and then we'll be, I've got 2 joined together as well. Perhaps if I put those and those together. No, I've got all 4 joined together now. Now they're all joined in a line. Could you blow again? And then perhaps we have 1, 2, 3, and 1 more comes off just like that over there. Oh, I've got a little ring on here, I forgot. If you hold that there like that and you go 1, 2, working. Hold it straight and I'll show you how it works. 1, 2, 3, just like that. And if I take one of the rings that I put down there and we go 1, 2, 3, 4, with a bit of luck, that should blow all the way over there and then come off into my fingers just like that. Washing machine. It's not a real washing machine. It's a Chinese washing machine. And inside my Chinese washing machine, I've got some smelly socks. What you have to do with the Chinese washing machine is you put the socks on the inside of the Chinese washing machine, just like this. When the socks are on the inside, you put the lid on and you turn the handle. And then the socks will come out nice and clean. Perfect. Oh no, shrunk. But they are clean. We'll have to try again. I'll put them in there. I'll put the lid on. And I'll stir that handle. It doesn't work by electricity. And this time, oh, that's better. They're perfect now. There we are. Right size. All fine. Yeah, hang on. They've got holes in them. If I put my foot in there, it'll go in there, out there, down there, around there, through there, out there. Holy socks, Batman. We'll have to try again. Put the lid on. Give it a stir round. And we'll open that and we'll have a... There we are. It's perfect now. Oh no, they've all joined together. If I put that on this foot, that'll get cold. If I put it on this foot, that'll get cold. Oh no, we'll have to try one more time. I just realised I forgot to use something. When you're doing the washing, you have to use powder to help you, don't you? So I'm going to get some powder and I'll put the powder in there. There we are. Shut the lid. Put a whir around like this. And I'll wiggle my fingers and I'll say, Hoco, Poco, fried fish and cocoa. That's a silly magic word. And with a bit of luck, I just realised I kept forgetting to tip it up and show you there wasn't anything else inside. There really isn't anything else inside except for this sock. And now it's lovely and clean. Bisto. Bisto? That's gravy powder. Oh, well, they are clean. So at least it was a success story. It's a silly joke, isn't it? Well, I've got a friend who's a little white rabbit and he's very shy because he's only three. And he's only three in rabbit years, and rabbit years aren't as long as people years, and he's only about one in people years. And when he comes out, sometimes he talks. If he comes out, say hello to him. He's called Melvin. Melvin, say hello to everybody. Say hello nicely. Hello nicely. Nobody's called nicely. Say hello properly. Which one's called properly? None of them are called properly. Are they 2 metres away? Yeah, they're at least 2 metres away. You're not. No, we live in the same house. It's fine. We don't need to socially distance. It's okay. Did you wash your hands? Yes, I washed my hands with a baked potato. No, you don't wash your hands with a baked potato. That's just the song. But you do wash your hands to keep them nice and clean. Melvin, would you like to do a song?
Yes, I think I'll do a pong.
Yeah, not do a pong. Sing a song.
All right, off you go then. I don't want to go. I want to sing it here.
Yeah, I know you want to sing it here. Just start singing the song.
Little boy blue, come blow on your horn. It's quarter past midnight and everyone's gone.
Yeah, no. Do them another one.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow? I don't know, said Mary, Mary, to them under the snow.
No. Do them another one.
Dolly, put the kettle on and wear it as a hat. I don't think I will, she said, I'd rather wear the cat.
Yeah, no. Do them another one.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jill fell down a silly girl, but luckily Jack caught her.
Yeah, no. Do them one more.
The Grand Old Duke of Yorkie Bar of Chocolate.
It is not the Grand Old Duke of Yorkie Bar of Chocolate. It's the Grand Old Duke of York.
The Grand Old Duke of York.
He carries on after that.
It carries on after that.
Yeah, no, that's not the words. He had some men.
He had 9,999 men.
He didn't. He had 10,000 men. What happened to the other one?
He was on holiday.
He wasn't on holiday. Put him back again.
He had 10,000 men. One had a suntan, he'd just come back from holiday.
Yeah, no. Where did he go for holiday?
To his garden. It was socially distanced.
Oh, yeah, to his garden. Okay, that's fair enough.
He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again, silly sausage.
He's not a silly sausage. Carry on singing.
And when they're up,
yes.
And when they're down,
yes.
And when they're only halfway up,
yes.
the trousers all fell down.
Yeah, no, you're not supposed to say that. Excuse me, what's the matter? Excuse me, what's the matter? Excuse me, what's the matter?
I want to go wee.
Yeah, I'm sorry about this, he's only little. You're not supposed to say that. I can't go wee. You're not supposed to.
I gotta go.
Okay, you can go.
Wee!
You silly rabbit, that's not what I thought you meant.
I bet you're glad it was.
Yes, I am glad it was. You go down there and we'll do everybody's favourite trick.
The last one.
Yeah, it is the last one, but they like it too. It's a card trick. So when I was little, my dad showed me this. Now, my dad wasn't really a magician, but he got me to take one of these cards. There we are, the Seven of Hearts. Doesn't really matter which one. And he got me to put the card upside down in the pack like that. And then he put the cards away in the box. And do you know what he did? He made the cards float. Now, he wasn't really magic, and I was only little. And what he was really doing was that. You could do that. You put a card in there and you hold on to it, it's going to hold everything up. But in my head, I was sure that what my dad had shown me was this. And I'll show you now. As he took the cards out, the cards stayed in the air till he gave a blow. And then they were all back together. Well, I hope you've enjoyed watching my little bit. It's been strange doing magic for you with knowing that you're watching, but I can't see you. I hope I'll see you soon. Take care, and bye for now. Don't forget to wash your hands. Bye.
Hello, folks. Turn it up a little bit. Hello, folks. Hope you're doing well. And happy to be here for the Stevenage Day. So they're actually raising money today for really important community charities and community causes. So it's in association with the Stevenage Reuse charity and also with Phelan's Farm. So if you can donate, please do. My name's Blake Baker. You can get me on social things as Blake Baker Music. I think this might be backwards from my camera. And I'm going to play some music for you. There's loads of music going on tonight, so I'm going to play you a little snippet now. And please check in and watch it later. So it's going to be on the YouTube channel. It's going to be streamed live from the YouTube channel from 5:30 this evening. And there's loads of different music and stuff going on as part of Stevenage Day. So thanks a lot.
I was tired of my lady, been together too long. Like a one-hour recording of a favorite song. While she lay there sleeping, read the paper in bed. And in the personal columns was this one that I read. If you like pina colada, getting caught in the rain, not in the yogurt. And if you have half a brain, you're like a hell of a midnight in the dunes of a cave. I'm the love that you're looking for. Run me and escape. Didn't think about my lady, no, it sounds kind of mean. Me and my old lady got stuck in the same old routine. So I wrote up the paper, I placed a personal ad. Though I'm nobody's poet, I thought it wasn't half bad. I like pina coladas, getting caught in the rain. I'm a merchant of health food. I am into champagne. I've got a million that I'm gonna do. Cut off all this red tape. Out of bar called O'Malley's, where we'll plan our escape. Thank you. I was getting kind of nervous when she walked in the place. Knew a smile in an instant, knew the curve of her face. Was my own lovely lady. She said, oh, it's you. Then we laughed for a moment. She said, I never knew. You're like Pina Coladas, getting caught in the rain. But you're not in a helpful, you are into champagne. Feel like making love at midnight, in the dunes of a cave. I'm the love that you look for, run to me and
thank you very much if you've been watching, and hopefully you'll be along later for the stream. Thanks a lot. See you this evening.
I knew I shouldn't have eaten those radishes. Oh, hello. Do you know, I haven't done this since I was in the army.
Yes.
Disgusting.
It's no good, sir. I can't get any sense out of her.
Leave it to me. I know how to handle this baggage. Now, look here.
We know very well you're a member of Big Dick's gang.
Of course, stone to crows. What's he talking about? You're a bloody dead loss.
How dare you?
We have ways of making you talk.
You couldn't help a dog find a bloody lamppost.
That's it!
Ha! Yeah, I'm getting in a second. I am the greatest. Oh, I don't bother. Thought I was back in the game then.
Ha! Holy! Give all. That's funny.
Had a good day.
Oh, not bad. Got drunk at lunchtime. Then went to a strip club. And finished up in bed with a popsy.
Oh, look. There's a hole in his tent flap.
Yes, the goat ate its way in last year.
Oh, yes, I remember. He was after your bedding.
Yes, that's right. He even left a deposit on it.
Oh, poor Peter. We had a good laugh about that, though, didn't we?
Yes, you did, didn't you?
Oh, Peter, I've been thinking we ought to try Devon again this year. We had such a marvellous time there last time.
I was wondering if possibly, you know, just once, we might go abroad somewhere.